My name's Aura Curran and I come from Cavan with my son Sean, who's 3.5. We are currently in receipt of the domicilary allowance, but we're currently waiting for a review to take place. I think it's just scandalous at this point regarding the process itself, so inhumane towards children. But once a child gets it, they should be in receipt until they're 16.
Currently, at the moment,
yeah. We were due a review in June.
In June of this year, and did you get that review?
We haven't got the review. We haven't been notified by Department of Social Protection why we haven't got a review as yet. It has taken us 3 months to compile all the information between paediatrician reports, medical reports from
the. And how long are you given for that review? Sorry.
We got the letter on the World Autism Day in April.
Oh, wow.
And we were given
nice time to get it coming through
the door, and we're supposed to be celebrating. And my son was only diagnosed with autism in February.
Wow.
But we are still waiting.
Everybody ready?
We're now in June, and we're actually going through the official process of the assessment process for to be diagnosed with autism.
Because something needs to be done. We need to have a revolution. We need to get the government out. We need them to get down and admit defeat. The people, we shouldn't have 100 people here. We should have 3 million people here telling the world that this is wrong. It's wrong to make us pay. It's wrong to take it from the children's savings boxes. Needs to end. All needs to come to an end. And fast.
Okay.
Four boys on the autism spectrum, varying degrees of autism, one with an entitlement to DCA, who will be reviewed in June 2014, but I'm not scared because they won't strike fear into me.
Have they cut your DCA at all? Or
no, it took me 37 weeks to get it put in the first place.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, with the government the way it is and the regulations in this country, you only get an entitlement when you apply for it. Yet, if you owe taxes, they can backdate it to the date that the tax was due.
Yeah.
Double standards. Yeah. Left, right and centre. There is no centre. It's left and right.
Yeah.
I know where I am.
Okay, Carol.
I'd just like to commend the DCA Warriors for having this protest today. I think the only way you are going to force the government's hand on this issue is if you keep fighting like this and keep putting the issue right in their face. I think insofar as the minister has backed off on the reviews of the DCA for people who were being threatened with review and possible loss of the DCA, it is directly as a result of your campaigning and protesting that the government have been put on the back foot. But as I think you all know very, very well, that is not the end of the story. And until there's a proper process put in place and where you are consulted, where the DCA and the real stakeholders, if you like, are consulted properly by the minister and a proper system of assessment is put in place, this battle won't be over. And we know that the pressure from the Troika and the austerity programme is to cut at these sort of vital supports and benefits. So you're going to have to keep up your fight, and I would just encourage you to keep up that campaign of protest over the coming weeks and months until you get the sort of commitments from the minister that you deserve. And I just want to say finally, if please keep me posted in the door about any updates or any further information. I mean, I was told, for example, that there's no psychologist in Cavan to do assessments. There may be other similar stories and problems around the country, so please keep us posted with any questions that we should be putting to the minister, because we have to keep harassing her in the Dáil as well as you out here on the streets doing it. So please let us know, keep up your fight, but well done for today.
Lourdes, I'm not going to take my child back the following year and say, oh look, I took him to Lourdes, look, he's great, straight A student. That's never going to happen. So why are they putting reviews in there to waste government money? It's just a pure waste of money.
Well,
it's
either, sorry, the only conclusion you could draw from the
if it was a review after the fact,
it's the bottom line. It's all about the bottom line.
That's the only logic I can get, because you're right in what you're saying.
There's no logic to it. There's absolutely no logic.
The fact is, you know, sometimes the needs may even...
Yeah, but it's not only that. The reports are valid for 2 years. So if they're going to come back and say to you, we're going to review your child in a year's time, you're going to be still giving in the same reports. Because they're valid for 2 years. You know, so
there's a lot of points that have to be changed.
I'm aware of, the child has one arm. The child was born with one arm and got a DCA. The child is up for review. Do they think she's going to grow an arm? That, it's not just autistic. It's not.
No, it's
just across autistic. The board, yeah.
It's across the board. The child is not going to grow a new arm by the following year. It's not going to happen. So her needs are going to be the same as it was the year before. So.